Hello everyone, and welcome to some Prismata. This is going to be the first in a series of videos, which are not altogether that different from my ordinary Prismata videos, but they are for the Prismata League, which has recently begun. the format is, it's bracketed into 8 divisions, right? They have the top league, top 2 leagues, I think it's 8. Anyway, we're in like the third tier of leagues. So there's two leagues higher than us and another league tied in like how strong it is. And it's a round robin over the course of a couple of months where you play each other player and you play 3 games against them. This is not a best of 3, you just play 3 games. And every win counts equally across the whole season. So that should be 36-ish games, I believe. I think there's 12 other players. I don't remember. Over the course of the next couple months. So this will not be a daily series, but I'll keep my daily Prismata series going and sprinkle this in whenever it happens to work out. So our first match is going to be against Zezatel, and I will see you guys when we start that match. Hello, everyone. Here we are. Welcome to match 1 against Zezatel. What do we have? Oh, I skipped. Oops. Skipped. 10-second countdown. okay, what's going on here? Seems pretty high econ stuff with, like, you could get a Lucina eventually behind Infusion Grid. Yeah, so we're probably going 3rd NG into, like, red-blue stuff. Flame Animus is good, but I don't think it's so good that I want to, like, cut drones for it in what is, to me, a relatively high econ set. I don't know, maybe he's gonna try to challenge with, Ice Blades, but no. I mean, Iceblade Gaustab is kind of a thing, but I don't think it's really a good thing. And I think I do want the Flame Animus before Grid. We're gonna want a lot of red. This is probably fine. This might be too many drones. No, I think it's alright. So I do want to get the Lucina going. Just gonna need a lot of drones to support it. I would have liked to get another Blast Forge at some point here. Actually, Lucina might be bad because of Ice Blades? Question mark? Right, like I can double Ice Blade comfortably on this tech and like maybe get. Yeah, that's an option I have open to me. And so is, like, Hannibal? Interesting. A Hannibal would leave me the opportunity to do a lot of pretty cool stuff, like, say, keep building Flame Animuses. And it'll take him a while to get over the Hannibal Absorb Barrier, I think. I mean, we're gonna want Arca eventually. Maybe I should think more about that instead of about, like, this Hannibal thing. It's like, how do I get to 7 attack, preferably while buying Lucina? So I can get a Hannibal here. Like, that is a thing that I can do. And then I can get another Flame Animus. It's just gonna be so long before I get Lucina this way, is the thing. It doesn't seem that great. What if I just built, like, a Hannibal to defend myself and get an Animus right now? Cut the drone, leaves me 17. Can't quite get the Lucina. It's a pretty good Lucina, right? I'll have to float some blue to get it, but that seems overall good. I like this idea. I think we hit him with Lucina right now. The wall maybe, I don't know, should have been something else, but... He's setting up for what looks like a pretty okay Lucina himself. Well, I can click the Arca, or the Hannibal, that's nice. And now we're gonna have 7 attack while holding the Hannibal, which is perfect. Cause he, he gets a pretty cool snipe of my Hannibal, you're right. With his 7 attack, but he can't get Arca if he's doing that. Oops, not Ice Blade. Arca. Now he's gonna have the Zatron. That's pretty cool for him. But I think that with Arca, like, Zatron's mostly just an attacker here, and it wasn't a terribly efficient attacker. 26. I'll need to spend 3, well, maybe just 2, right? Yeah, I can easily spend all this tech. And I'll click the Hannibal, because Arca is, like... Oh, this kind of sucks, doesn't it? Maybe I shouldn't get the Arca yet. Because Arca is absorbing for 0 this turn. Yeah, there's that, isn't there? Okay. So I want to be in a position to Arca next turn. 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, that's reasonably comfortable. So let's just build some more Tarsiers. And a Flame Animus, I guess. Because he wants... No, he doesn't want Arca, does he? Neither of us really. Ugh. He just wants to click the Hannibal, right? Oh, well, don't build drones if you're... Okay, this makes the turn much nicer. Still not great, but actually should be a grid. So that it's... Four, five, six, seven. I think a grid is okay. But a splitter might be better. Or another Flame Animus? Phew, that would be something. Yeah, because we're not planning to attack much next turn, right? Oh, he couldn't Arca, of course. I always forget to, like, check, does my opponent have the tech to build the thing I'm worried about them building? If not, don't worry about it. Especially Arca, where, like, the 7 attack is a much more dominant requirement. Like, it's not too hard to get blue-blue-red, but to get 7 attack and, like, time it well is usually a bigger concern. Now we're getting the Arca. And just like a shitload of Tarsiers, right? Should they maybe be Immolites? He's counter-arcing so well here. Why am I giving this to him? What if I just build this? Doesn't feel great. Well, we're denying him quite a bit this turn anyway, right? Because his Zatron was actually doing something good. Alright, I'm gonna just build it. I'm not sure. And I'm gonna actually click Lucina instead of building a Tarsier. I'm gonna have so much red that a Perforator is pretty good. I do feel like I'm losing. But I guess I have a lot more permanent attack, maybe? Not a lot more, but some. Four Immolites, the power play. Okay. I mean, this seems alright. I really would love to get a Hannibal at some stage here. We're sort of at the point where that's useful. But I don't have any way to do that, so I guess I'm not going to. Five's a big deal for him to cope with, isn't it? I guess he has a lot of force fields. Yikes. He did build a lot of green here. This is the worst. I thought I was going to be able to spend this red, but that's clearly incorrect. Should he really be clicking his Arca here? I think he should be alternating between Arca and Zatron, but I don't know. I mean, I guess this makes me lose four attack. This is pretty bad. Yeah, I think he's got me. But, you know, Immolite's coming in. We'll see. No, he has force fields. And he's killing three attack. Right, like this no longer works, really. I'll keep trying. It is, after all, a competitive match, but I don't see how I can win. Yeah. He's able to buy a grid. Okay, that was game one. I'm just gonna cut here, and I'll see you guys in game two. Here we go, game two against Zezatel. And this time we remembered to have this enabled. Another like super high econ game, huh? I do like all the pixie generating units. I feel like I'm reasonably good with them. I think we're all getting to Centurion eventually. Although there's like something to be said for Thermite Core. Do I do something like this? Is this right here? I think it might be that high econ. I mean, Thermite Core sort of punishes Centurion, and so does Isochronus, but like there's Mobile Animus, there's a million ways to drone up. I feel like this has got to be right. There's nothing to punish this super high econ opening. No aggression in the set at all. And we should be able to get to Centurion in time. Like, what is he gonna do? Get an Animus? No. Sure, Conduit. That's pretty good. Conduit's a good unit. Interesting. I would really like a Conduit here, so we're probably doing something like this. Isochronus. I guess that's a cool way to set up for Thermites, right? Maybe just this, so that it's a little bit less good for him to click the Thermite Core, because he could click a Galvani. I don't know. This way I don't float any energy and I still can Vivid next turn. I think we're just not building a wall in response to this ISO, because he clearly wants to Thermite it. Second green. Are we in that much of a hurry to get Gauss Fab? Doesn't seem that way to me. But maybe there's just nothing else good to do with the money? Yeah, triple Galvani seemed weird to me. If he wants to kill two engineers, you know, he's welcome to do that. I'm just gonna get a Thermite Core here. And replace the engineers, since he's sort of effectively killing them anyway with the Thermite Core. I don't see any reason to do anything weird. I could get a Blast Forge here. Yeah, I won't mind being able to build like Oxide Mixers if nothing else. Although, maybe a Conduit is better. We'll want a lot of green eventually, right? And this way I'm saving it up a bit better. Click Galvani to build more drones? Why? I don't quite get that. More engineers here for some reason? I don't think so. I think I'd rather have the Blast Forge. Feel behind on everything again. I'm up on drones, I guess. This wall's really not doing anything. Well, it sort of is, because he could actually breach and kill drones. Another thermite core, though? No, because he's just not building walls. So I guess the oxide mixer is better. Although this allows him to build a wall and get value. No, because I can kill Galvanis, so it's not that great for him. I don't really want to disrupt. Right now, like, I have an odd number, which is good, because I want... Oh, no, this is four. Yeah. I thought it was five, but no, that's Satron. Ugh, the Centurion's just going to be too early. I can't do that. Is it worth clicking a pixie to kill a Galvani? Probably, right? So I have a choice. I can do this if I want, which is sort of worse in a way, because like killing Galvanis is better than having pixies, right? We decided that. But this way I can deny him absorb for longer. If I just kill all four pixies, then next turn I won't be able to deny him absorb. So I think this is a better compromise. Still definitely don't feel good about my position. My advantage is substantially more drones, right? That's certainly something that I have. Can't build a Centurion yet. I mean, I guess I could have clicked the Mobile Animus. That might be a thing to try, actually. How much attack is he? He's got 4, 7 attack. Yeah, he can easily, like, make me get 0 absorb this way. Well, 1 absorb. Meanwhile, I'm attacking for 4, 5, 6, 7, And, like, I can't really reduce it by anything meaningful, so he can build a good Centurion. I think I just need to get it down now, or I'm never going to be able to, even though it's not getting good value. He has out-pixied me. I can give him a tiny bit less value in this way, but it's not that great, right? It might just be better to attack him. Yeah, probably right. Oh my god, how do I even defend? I have to hold the Rhino to defend? That doesn't defend. I have to do more than hold the Rhino. This is awful. ISO, really? I guess it lets you get at another engineer. A gas cannon would be the more normal thing to do, but maybe he thought that engineer was going to be worthwhile. This sort of exploits him a tiny, tiny bit. Oh, but this doesn't defend? Shit. I don't have any more prompt defense, right? There's no way I can get more defense than this. And then I just lose the Centurion. Well, it's gonna be a rough match. Alright, so as before, I'll just cut here and see you guys in the next. Hello everyone, welcome back to game 3 of my match against Ezetel. This is our third and final game, but it's not a best of 3, it's just to play 3 games and win as many as you can. So even though I lost the first 2, we're going to continue playing here. And we agreed to a post-match interview sort of thing? So hopefully that'll be coming up after this. What the heck is all this? It seems reasonably high econ. I'd rather have been player 2, I think. Because Natural Conduit into Natural Blast Forge looks pretty good here. Or doing the same thing after building a third engineer and more drones. The main thing that gives me pause here is, like, Vi sort of counters the Doomed Mechs, but, you know, you don't have to build Doomed Mechs. You can build Urban Sentries instead if your opponent is, like, in the Vi plus Ice Blade world, and then Urban Sentries are really good. So are we getting third engineer? Is Doomed Mech enough to make that good? I think it's not. Right? I think I just want to get out some tech early-ish. He is in a great position having a natural conduit available, because then he can build like a third drone via Trinity drone in a way. Hmm. Yeah, I think. Well, I think if you commit too hard to Doomed Mechs, you sort of get punished by Vi, but. Maybe this is fine. Isn't it? Like, the opponent doesn't really want to go for Vi, and building a third engineer, if it, like, pulls them off of the green-blue monster they're sitting on, like, maybe that's fine. Green and red, huh? Well, I guess the green is fine because Trinity drones, right? He's not actually committing to the Scorchilla or anything green. This is probably enough drones. Second Blast Forge here. But it's a little early for Doomed Mechs, but like Hellhounds or Ice Blades would be fine. Yeah, in fact, let's just get another Trinity. Here comes Vi. Sentries. They kind of suck because they're not attacking at all this turn against his sentry, but. Man, this is gonna be a rough season. This is my first league match of. What is it like? 12, I think, that you play over the course of a season? Just does not feel good at all right now. So this defends, but so would holding a drone. And actually, if he freezes, like if he makes the drone defend, he'd have 8 attack. No, this does not defend. This also does not defend, right? Yes, correct. This defends. So, do we want to get Hellhounds or Ice Blades? I think is the big question. Well, we kind of need Urbans, right? Ice Blades are timed reasonably well. It's not convenient for him to kill them, even though he can. It means giving up on killing my other stuff. God, I just feel like nothing I do is right today. And I think that that's just because Zezatel's a better player than I am. Not because I'm, like, doing anything worse than usual. guess we'll make him defend with the engineers. This defends. So he has 11 plus 3 is 14. This defends. Doesn't feel great though, I'll tell you that. Yikes. I forgot he could target them. I didn't even count how much he would have if he didn't try to breach me. So this is 13 and 3 is 16. I'm like miles behind. I'm never gonna win this. He has so much more attack. And I don't have anything to show for it. Yeah, this is horrible. Okay, well, stay tuned and we'll have a post-match interview with Zezatel where I'll try to keep my spirits up. Hello everyone, welcome to my post-game interview of sorts with Zezatel. Congratulations on your wins, etc., etc. We were about to start looking at the second game when I was sad that every game was such a blowout. He claims game two was close, but I don't think that's really true.
So, well, did we both just go Fivits?
Yeah, of course. I mean, I fourth engineer is, like, clearly right. But I
agree that choice there.
Yeah.
And then I wanted to go for Gauss Fab. I was fairly sure I wanted to get that. But then with Tomite Core, I also wanted to get Isos just because the two is fairly convenient.
Yeah, plus you can, like, build the ISO and then on the next turn build the Thermite. You don't have to build them together.
Yeah. I had one conduit, one green, and I was like, I might as well just buy an ISO and I'll just delay the guy's fab a bit.
Yeah. I don't know. I just like didn't build enough thermite cores. I guess I didn't get my second blue fast enough, right? Is the main thing?
Yeah. On turn 7, you built an oxide mixer, which could have been a thermite core, I guess.
It could have, but I was thinking like, what's the point? If I have a thermite core,
that's not getting clicked.
It's not getting clicked. You're just like going to continue not defending, right?
Yeah. I think it should just end the entire game with just one thermite, which you definitely needed more this in that set.
Yes. Like, I don't know, a third blast forge doesn't seem right, but like, the Oxide Mixer is actually producing pixies, whereas a Thermite Core would just be converting engineer kills into pixies, which is not so great.
Maybe a mobile Animus into Rhinos that then attack and, like, defend, but they don't get killed on the defense because I'm clicking my Thermite Cores.
That's an idea. Get the mobile Animus a bit sooner. The Rhino is a convenient way to threaten to defend.
Yeah. Well, I didn't really like the mobile Animus either. I got it very late as well, so can't really blame you.
Yeah, it was like, you clearly want Centurion, but all of these Thermite Cores left me in a spot where I could never actually get it profitably.
Yeah.
And
I had also a few turns, like, I want Centurion, but if I get Centurion, he'll do, like, one damage into it.
Yeah. And that was like where all of your extra thermite cores helped. Which I clearly you want a lot of them, but I couldn't figure out how to get them while also doing reasonable things. Maybe I just got too many drones.
That was... You had more drones than I did. You had one more Vivid and one more regular drone. So
I had two more Vivids at
that's
one,
quite
for
a lot
while,
more.
I thought. Didn't I? Maybe it was just one more. You're right.
Well, one more Vivid is
yeah, it's
three more
deal,
drones. So
yeah.
It's a lot.
Okay, well, let's go have a quick look at game one, I guess. And
where... In game one, there was an interesting... You had the possibility to get an Arca, and I couldn't counter Arca, but I could kill your Hannibal for exactly 7 damage.
Yeah, exactly. I didn't...
That was...
I liked the Hannibal way to make let myself defend for a while, but it fits badly with the fact that you also want to Arca, and you can just do both, like kill the Hannibal and then Arca.
Yeah. On turn, it's turn 8, you could get Arca out, and I couldn't get an Arca because I only had one Blast Forge at that time.
Yeah.
But then I just kill your Hannibal.
Yeah, exactly.
So I think there was something wrong there.
Yeah. And I never really got an Infusion Grid out in time either. I think my early wall should have just been a grid. Normally I would build a grid here, but I figured with Hannibal, like... the extra value from grid is minimal.
I just got one more absorb, and then I have Zadron as well, which gives me even more absorb.
Yeah, I mean...
Zadron was pretty big there, I think,
yes.
In that set.
I'm not sure how I was supposed to fit
just
in.
Just green in general, because by the later turns, I'm constantly attacking with Arca because I'm killing 3-4 damage, and Zadron gets pretty decent absorb anyway.
Yeah.
There were even turns where Zadron was on 5 health, but Arca is killing 3 damage, so I'm attacking with Arca, and then you hold your Arca back, and you're holding a Perf back, and then I absorb on the Infusion, and Zadron is happy.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm player 2, so I had the easier conduit, but I feel like you somehow should have gotten Zadron as well. Both with and against Arca is pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, I guess I could just get the conduit on turn 4. Blue wasn't... But I thought the Flame Animus was pretty important as well.
You needed 2 Flame Animus, yeah.
Yeah. Maybe
I'm
I
not
can...
sure if you needed 4.
Well, so of course I don't need 4, but my thinking was, like, look, here it is turn 9, right? And what am I going to do with this? Build splitters? I'm just going to Arca next turn. They're not doing any damage. These were just, like, cheaper splitters, I thought.
Yeah,
although I guess they can't defend.
They're not horrible.
Alright, let's look at game 3 real quick. I thought Vi was going to be hard to get, but it was not hard at all.
Wait, I thought Vi was like a must get because of Doomdmech, and then you went high econ and was like, oh, he's getting Doomdmechs.
Yeah, okay. I mean, that was... I was thinking, like, okay, yes, obviously Vi is good against Doomed Mechs, and I don't know.
I think you made it too easy for me to get Vi, because I'm looking at this game now, it's turn 6. I'm getting my Urban Sentry, there's no damage on the board yet at your side.
Yeah.
Not even build time Tarsiers. I can just get the... I didn't expect to get a sentry like without any. I expected to have to get a wall and then maybe a sentry.
Yeah.
I think you just the high ecom into no damage was too passive. I think.
Yeah, I thought that perhaps like my thinking was that Vi might be hard to get because I could get Ice Blades to, like, Vi's a big commitment and it's fairly breach vulnerable tech. I would be able to freeze your stuff, but I gave you enough time to get out to sentry, so like that doesn't really work very well.
Yeah, then you get double sentry, and I'm just like, okay, well, we win now.
Yeah. So it's been a good season for you so far, right? The league season?
I'm 6-4. No, wait, I won 7 games, and I lost 5, so 7-5. Because I kind of goofed against Book. Well, Book's got played well. I'll put it.
Oh
that
yeah,
way.
That's right. You had the he 3-0.
But that
you.
Wasn't the greatest. Yeah.
All right, so this is making up
so
for
that.
That
didn't.
Then.
Yeah, and then 2-1 win. So I don't know. I think if I keep up this percentage, that's like third, fourth place. So not good enough, but pretty good.
Okay. Well, thanks for the match. Good luck
now
in the rest.
Now I still have hope. Promote. Hmm?
Thanks for the match. Good luck in the rest. And
thanks for this
interview.
It was well. Good luck. If you beat them, that's good for me now.
Yeah, I guess so. Bye.
Bye.
All right, guys. There was the winner's interview with Zezatel. What a disastrous match, huh? Oh, well. A lot to learn, and this base plus 9 is a bit much. I feel like I'm okay at base plus 9, but every one of these had like a lot of complicated things going on, and my opponent just did a better job of finding builds that put together the strong things, right? Okay, well, I hope you guys enjoyed this slightly different format here. Can look forward to more competitive league matches in the future, I suppose. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.